Welcome back to my channel. In this session we are going to build a project for remote tester. We can test IR remote using this project. It will show the IR code which is being transmitted from IR window, and it will display the key names. So we can define any key name based on the key location. Let's check it. I will press the power on button. It is showing FFA25D. We can monitor also on the serial monitor. In the serial monitor is showing FFA25D power key, FFE21D mute, volume down, volume up, zero. We will build this project step by step and we will write the code, and I will try to explain everything in detail. Let's start. To make this project, we need project board, IR receiver. This receiver is 3-pin terminal component. You can use a simple discrete component as a IR receiver, or you can use IR receiver module. It have a built-in LED. The other function will remain same, just only the difference is pin out. The right side pin, that is signal pin, and the center pin, that is positive, and the left pin, that is ground pin, hold in this condition. Okay, I will place it here in the project board. In this condition, the right pin, that is signal pin. We need Arduino board. You can use any Arduino. I am using Arduino Uno. Rightmost pin, that is signal pin. So signal pin is connected to pin number 2. We will use 2, 3, any digital IO pin. And we use 5 volt positive from this board, and we will provide to center pin, and the left pin, it will be connected to ground pin. Basically, it is a question from my viewer. Nice video, please make a video on remote testing and software check of the remote with Arduino, and please attach a 16 by 2 display with this software. I will use 1602A 16 by 2 LCD. This module is using I2C interface. When we use I2C interface, this interface reduces the number of wires, so the project will very simple and easy. The wire connection, first pin that I connected black header wire, it is ground. So ground we will connect to ground. Second pin VCC, we will connect both pins here. Ground at the left side, positive in the center. Then we have two wires here. The rightmost pin, SCL clock pin, it will come to A5 pin of this Arduino board. There are dedicated pins here, but we will use here in the analog portion. SDA pin, the data pin, it will come to A4. So we completed the connections. Let's open the Arduino IDE. Enter here definition files, sketch, include library, liquid crystal I2C. Then we need include library wire.h. Then we need library for this IR remote. If you cannot find these library files, you can download from the internet. We will assign the name for this liquid crystal LCD. Type here LCD. Now give the address 0x27, comma 16 characters, 2 lines. 16 characters, 2 lines, and the physical address, that is 0x27. And we can add comment SCL to A5, SDA to A4. This is the pin connections. Now we will define the IR pin, that is pin number 2. Constant integer receiver pin, that is the pin function name for our IR remote. Receiver pin, that is pin number 2. Now give a name to be used in the software. IR RECV. IR RECV. We will use this name in our software. From which pin? From this pin. and when it will receive data, it will decode that results into results. Now we assigned a name LCD. We will use this name in the program, and we assigned a name to pin number 2, that is receiver pin, and we said receive IR receiver. That will be used in IR remote definition file. It will say IR receiver, from where it will take signal from receiver pin, that is pin number 2, and when it will receive data, then it will decode that results into results. We will use this name in the software. Let's initialize LCD dot initialize. We initialize the LCD. When it will run the software first time, it will program this LCD. Then LCD dot backlight, LCD dot set cursor 0, first character row. This is the location from where it will write. LCD dot print. We will display a message here, IR remote tester. We will give a delay time for display, that is 1000 millisecond, 1 second. This message will appear for 1 second, and then LCD dot clear. It will clear the LCD. Now we want to initialize, enable this IR. So when it will run, it will seek IR signal from this sensor. So IR RECV, this is the name which we assigned here, enable IR capital N. Yes, we enable the IR. If we want to send this data to the serial port, we can also initialize serial dot begin. The standard baud rate of Arduino, that is 9600, at this baud rate it will start to send data to our computer. In the program body we will say if IR receiver is available, decode it and results. So it will decode that data and it will store in this variable, that is results. Now we will assign functions. When it will receive data, it will decode in the results. What we want to do, serial dot print, we want to take this data which it will receive, we want to take on the serial port. Serial dot print ln what results value dot value in hex format. And if we want to send the same data on the screen, LCD dot set cursor where first column first row, LCD dot print copy. When it will receive data, it will send to serial port and it will send to LCD. Then it need to become ready for the next cycle. We completed the program. Here we defined the LCD, we defined the IR module, we defined the address and the location, display size, and then we defined the pin number here, and then we initialized the pin, we defined the pin role, and we stored the results in here, wide setup, initialized LCD, backlight, cursor, and print IR remote tester. Delay this, LCD clear, yes, enable IR in serial port and IR decode results into results. Then serial, the received results will be sent to the serial port. Then display on the LCD and resume. Upload this program in the Arduino. Now I am uploading the program, yes, IR remote sensor. I will open the serial monitor. Serial monitor, yes, I pressed. We can see on the serial if it is showing FFA25D, and here is showing FFA25D, and there is some garbage. And if I will keep pressed in the key, it is showing some data and then FFF. To overcome this issue, before resuming, we will give a delay. delay, we will give 300 milliseconds. So it will not take a repeated action, it will give a delay time for new measurement. Yes, now it is giving good reading, FFA25D. Now we want to add the name of these keys, unsigned long key underscore value is equal to 0. If a results value is equal to 0x, how much numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6F. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Results value is equal to key value. Initial value is 0. Now we will use switch function to compare the values and display the names. Case 0x FFA FFA25D colon. When the case value, when the received value will equal to this, what it will do? Serial dot println power key. It will display message that power key button is pressed. Then we will say LCD dot set cursor. We will display in the second row, first character here, first column, 0, 1. 0 is the first column, second row. We will print the same message on the LCD. LCD dot print. We will say break. Press the power button. Yes, power key is pressed. Now power key is pressed. We can use, and now we will check the other button. For example, I want to check the mute button. I will copy this statement here and I will paste this statement set here, and I will change just only the number here, FFE21D, and it is mute button, M-U-T-E, and we will put some spaces. We will copy these parameters and we will also send to the serial port. Yes, we can assign the same numbers to different buttons. For example, if I will press 0, so FFB04F, FFB04F, so it is 0 0. If I will press volume down button, FF 6897 6897, volume down, case 1, volume up FF 98 9867, volume up. Okay, that's enough. You can add any remote. Now let's upload. I will open the serial monitor here now. First power button, FF25AD, power key, mute. The both functions are visible on the serial monitor and LCD. 0, volume up, volume down. We did not assign the name for 1, 2, 3. You can assign the same way. If you want to add any number, any key from the remote, just only copy this statement, paste it, and made the code which is visible here and which is visible on the serial monitor, and enter the name. When you will press any key, the number, data, its hex data and pin function will display it here. You can verify the remote function. So in this way we can monitor the codes transmitted by the remote, and we can also monitor the pin functions. Let's see here why it is showing the garbage here with these digits. Because at serial port we are taking the good data. Yes, this is the problem. Just only we need to print lcd.print, so it's okay. Now we'll upload. Now I uploaded the data again. Yes, now it is giving clear display. That's nice. 1, 2, 3, 0, volume up, volume down. In this way we can configure all the numbers. Just only copy this block from case until break. Change the code here and give the key name. The code is working now. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.